was check, check, checking. Mm-hmm. And it was time for you to have a baby.
Yep.
And you picked somebody who had 7 children and, according to you, if I read your complaint, is very often out of work. So you were trying to make a silk purse out of a sow's ear. That's very hard. That's not on anybody but you.
Okay.
Yeah, so, just a second. So okay. You're living as a family. You don't get rent. If you call him to pick up the child, then you have to rely on his judgment. If you don't like his judgment, and if you have custody, don't call him again. His judgment was, to take the child to urgent care and let urgent care call an ambulance to take him over to the hospital.
For a cold. And if I, for a cold.
I don't. Listen to me.
All right. I don't understand.
We're going to get back.
I don't understand how the rent isn't applicable. We broke up. He was still supposed to pay rent.
He owes you $180 for setting off the alarm. Now I'm entertaining his counterclaim. What did you do with his things?
Judge Judy continues in a moment. And later today.
The $770 came out of my bank.
Your heart.
You pay.
Choice.
The most important
free investing class near you.
Would Shakespeare have chosen just
how to sue it for the value of his property?
What did you do with his things?
I put his things out.
Where?
Out on the curb.
Oh. What did you put out on the curb?
Clothes and whatever he left in my house.
On what date did you put it out on the curb?
It was at the end of March. He refused to come get his things.
I'd like to see evidence that he refused to get his things.
Okay. So, here's the underlying text in the police report where they confirm that refused civil arrangements.
Just a second. Is that what you want me to see, that page?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. That page, Bird. Oh, that's not what was said at all. First of all, this conversation took place on April 3rd, after you'd already thrown out his property.
Okay. He had 60 days, though, to get it from the time.
What? You wanted him a week after this happened, despite the fact that you had a protective order. Mm-hmm. You called him to go and pick up the child from daycare, and I assume take him home, because you said all he had was a cold.
Not my house.
And just a second.
Yeah. Mm. Ma'am, I couldn't leave work. I had no one else. I'm a single mother. I barely have any family. I had no one else. I had to call him.
Okay. Judgment on the counterclaim for $500. Your claim is dismissed. It's subsumed by the counterclaim. We're done here. Thank you very much.
Wait a minute. What's for $500? What's $500?
You owe him five.
Why do I owe him money?
For throwing out his belongings.
He had ample time to get it, and the police aren't pursuing criminal charges against me. I was supposed to wait till April to get his stuff.
Jeff, excuse me.
You know, you are a piece of dad. You don't call
me. Leave your paper.
He's not there for his son. He pretends like he is.
Most definitely been very vindictive. You know, she threw away my computer that had all my music, my photography on it.
He is not. He has not seen his son since February.
I mean, she knew who I was and how successful I was.
He doesn't pay child support. He doesn't pay anything for him.
So, I mean, that was a way to, you know, get me.
The least his piece could have did was paid the back rent that he owed.
You know, everybody in the world get to see exactly what type of woman I was dealing with.
But that's what I get for picking.